Hello everyone! In this video I want to show you how we can perform human face recognition by using MATLAB. First of all, we should download a dataset for this project. I downloaded the ORL dataset which provided by Cambridge University. You can easily download it. As you can see, the dataset organized in 40 different folders and each folder is corresponding to one subject. Inside each folder you can see there are 10 images and the extension of the images are PGM. These images are numbered from 1 to 10. These are 10 images for subject 1. And these are the images of subject 2. So in this data set we have images of 40 subjects. So totally we have 40 times 10 or 400 images in this data set. Since these images are organized in the different folders, you can easily load all of this data into your MATLAB program by using image data store. Let me explain my code line by line. The ORL dataset stored in my computer in derived C and the folder name is face dataset. So in this line I create the path and then by using image data store function I load the whole dataset into the memory. Also we use the directory name or folder names as the subject's label. Let me run the code till this point. As you can see, after I load my data set we have a variable IMDS, image data set data store. And if I open the image data store, you can see that it consists of several properties. We have 400 images, and all of the image path and their name are stored in the files. And in the labels property, you can see the label of each of these images. The first image belongs to the subject 1, also the second one, third one. In fact, the first 10 images belongs to the subject 1, the second 10 images belongs to subject 2. So you can see 3 of them are shown here and there are more 397 categorical label here. Let me show you one of the images by using imread function. It's inside my image data store files number 1. This is the path for the file. As you can see, the image size is 112 by 92 and it's grayscale, unsigned integer 8. If I want to show you by using image show, so this is the first sample of the subject number 1, S1. If I show you another subject, another sample of this subject in different figure, as you can see different samples of a subject have a small variation in position, illumination, facial expressions. Let me load another sample. This is a sample from subject. If I want to find the label of this subject, I should use labels. This belongs to the subject 11. All of the data and the annotations are loaded into the memory. Now, in the next step, I have to split my data set into two sections, the training set and the test set. For this purpose, there is a function split each label. I should give it my image data store. Also, I should mention how percentage of the image of each class should be selected for training, and the remaining should be selected for test. Or you can mention how many image or how many samples you want to select from each class. So here I said that 6 images from each label should be selected for training. So 60% of the samples will be used for training, and the remaining 40% will be used for testing. And how we select this 60%? By mention randomize here. Every time you run this program, the system randomly selects 60% of the samples from each subject and use it for the training, and the remaining ones will be used for test. So if I run till this point, you can see that I have image data store train and image data store validation. Let me check them. As you can see, are selected for training, and ...160 images are selected for test. So here I count how many samples I have in the train set and how many sample I have in the test set. You can find it in different ways. So this is a feature set variable. I declare it to store the feature vector of the training set. I will use it here. Now we need to convert each of the image in the train set into the feature vector. I need a loop. Start from 1 to the number of samples in the train set. I read image one by one and put them in the train image. Then by using some feature descriptors such as local binary pattern, histogram of oriented gradient, or hook features, we can convert each image into some numerical representation. In this example, I use local binary pattern features. As you can see, as the first parameter, I gave it the image, and I mentioned that the cell size is 32 by 32 pixel. The local binary pattern feature extractor divides an image into several cells and then compute the LBP feature for each of these patches, and then concatenate these features to each other and use it as the extracted feature. Let me show you the MATLAB documentation of this function. This is the general syntax of the extract LBP features function. You can run it with one parameter, and the input image should be given to the function, or you can mention some name and value pairs here. As I said, the LBP feature divides the image into several sections. The size of these cells are mentioned as the parameter in the function. I assume that the size is 32 by 32 pixels. And then for each of these separate cell, the LBP feature will be extracted and concatenated to each others here. And the result of this concatenation will be used as the feature.